man, death to yuppies too, death to art fags, bourgeois blacks, death to landlord Jews. Kill the bankers, kill the cops, kill him, her, and me. Kill them all for CBS, NBC, ABC, TVN, CNN, HBO, Live at Night, MTV, Spring Break, Audio Weekend, Sally, Jesse, Raphael, Geraldo, Woodruff, Arsenio, Regis, and Kathy. And I said, hey, I admire your get up and go, your youthful brooding and sexually charged enthusiasm, and all your other utterly naive and thoroughly endearing adolescent qualities, and I bet you can keep it up all night, can't you? But I bet you don't even use a rubber. No, you don't even use a rubber. No, you don't even use a rubber. No, you can't, you don't, can't even. How's ya? Think you're gonna live forever? Or you have this adorable and misguided notion that death is something really radical and cool, but I still can't be wildly attracted to your fresh-faced, uncompromised, tattooed rebel stance, and goddamn, I'd like to have you sing your tune. But I've been making friends with his ear death, and it seems trying to be flippant here or irreverent or exploitive or sarcastic or ironic or postmodern, and this is not a parody. Get it? Got it? Good. I've been thinking what he told me, that it's okay to cry when we held the crystal Tina child. But it looks so fabulous on you, so why don't you take it on home? And speaking of home, is it about time you moved out of that East Village hellhole, you know, the one with the honeymooner's view of the brick wall out the window? Because you deserve something more like affirming, like a tree or a flower or a patch of grass or a singing little bluebird. Or maybe you just want to take your boyfriend to Europe because he's never been, or had the job you always hated, or learn how to play the guitar. It's easy. Or get obscenely drunk at a piano bar, sing show tunes, show tunes. And don't be embarrassed, because at this point I'd rather see Brigadoon than Henry Portrait of a Serial Killer. Or maybe you'd like to get politically active, so you disrupt a presidential press conference by shoving a 5-pound week-old stalk of broccoli between those thin lying lizard lips that no one can read anyway, because half the country's illiterate and the other half is apathetic, including the first lady who couldn't step just 500 feet of the over-decorated White House to visit the goddamn quilt. Or maybe you'd like to put a bullet into Jesse Helms' pea brain, but you know, when you start thinking like that, when you start thinking like they do, that it's time to let go of the material world. So maybe you'd just like to get yourself some religion, 'cause Jesus is the way, Jesus is the way, Jesus is the way, Jesus is the way, Jesus is the way. Besides, it's a lot easier to accept Jesus Christ as your personal savior when he looks like Willem Dafoe. But maybe that stuff turns you off, so your rent power of myth made me feel really good for about 10 minutes. Or maybe you'd just rather do acid and listen to
again, the last time I took hallucinogenic drugs was about 5 years ago. I took mushrooms in Joshua Tree, looking for that Carlos Castaneda's kind of experience. I got off, my boyfriend didn't, he fell asleep, left me alone with the television. Turned it on, put on PBS. You know what was on? Berlin Alexanderplatz. So I started watching it, and you know what? I got really bummed out. And that's when I said no to drugs, no to drugs, no, 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 hell no to drugs. And maybe you want to say no to drugs too, or maybe you just want to join Atheists of America, the Madonna fan club, or watch Richard Gere, follow the Dalai Lama across the world, and then do those oh-so zen-like movies with those oh-so zen-like messages like, hey, it's fun to be a prostitute. I can't wait to spread my legs across Hollywood Boulevard, because then maybe some rich, handsome billionaire in a Jag will come driving up and take me shopping on Rodeo Drive. And that's what a woman's all about anyway, right? Sucking and chopping, sucking and chopping, sucking, chopping, sucking, chopping, sucking and chopping, sucking and chopping. Come on, it's a sing-along. Sucking and chopping, sucking and chopping, sucking and chopping, sucking and chopping. But hey, who am I to argue? Because it's the feel-good movie of the summer. It's the feel-good movie of the year. It's the feel-good movie of the 90s. It's the feel-good movie of the millennium. And you know what? If it puts a smile on your face and a song in your heart and a spring in your step, well, whatever makes you happy, 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 whatever gives you hope, even if it's all truly tasteless joke. So, facts, a manifesto, pencil in a day.